If we look at Vladimir Putin's presidential aircraft from the outside, there isn't much difference compared to a typical commercial airliner. It can be said that 95% of it is a standard aircraft. What might differ is the size of the plane. There's no airline logo, only Russian writing, and the flag's colors stretch from the front to the back of the plane right above the wings, while on commercial planes, it's usually on the underside. In total, Putin has 5 planes. The first was assembled in 1995 for Boris Yeltsin, and then the following 4 types were built for Vladimir Putin. Now, the question arises, why are there 5 planes, and why isn't one enough? We'll discuss this, but simply put, the operation of more than one plane is for security reasons. We're talking about the Ilyushin Tu-96-300PU, Il-96-300PU, the Russian presidential aircraft. Originally designed as a commercial plane, it was modified to accommodate the transportation needs of one of the world's most powerful heads of state. This plane is even nicknamed the Flying Kremlin. Why is it called that? It's due to the advanced features of the aircraft, which we will explore in this video. The Ilyushin Tu-96-300PU is indeed produced in Russia, but not mass-produced like the Boeing models used to transport the President of the United States. The Tu-96 essentially has 2 variants, and the Il-96-300 was launched in 1985 and began operation in 1993. Specifically, the Russian presidential fleet is designated with the letters PU behind the plane's model number, indicating that these aircraft are specially modified for presidential duties. The construction of the Ilyushin Tu-96-300PU is based on the IL-96, which itself is a wide-bodied passenger aircraft designed for medium and long-haul airline flights. This model was developed by Ilyushin, a leading Russian company in aviation design and manufacturing. The IL-96 made its first flight in 1988 and has been in mass production since 1993. In terms of size, the Ilyushin Tu-96 of the 300PU type is slightly smaller and shorter than other variants such as the Il-96M/T or Il-96-400. The wingspan of the Tu-96-300 is about 189 feet with a length of 181.5 feet and a fuselage diameter of approximately 20 feet. Its payload capacity reaches 88,185 pounds with a maximum takeoff weight of 551,155 pounds. The maximum passenger capacity is 300 people, in addition to 3 crew members. Historically, the Tu-96-300 was a plane built using Western technology, including 4 Pratt and Whitney PW2337 engines. However, due to disputes with Boeing, these engines were replaced with PS-90A turbofan engines, also consisting of 4 engines. What are the advantages of a 4-turbine engine? Certainly, maintenance and fueling are significantly more expensive. However, with a 4-turbine engine, the aircraft has greater autonomy in terms of safety. This means that a plane with 4 turbines can make an emergency landing even if only 2, or even just 1, of its engines are operational. In the latter case, the plane can still cover a distance of up to 497 miles and land safely. Another difference is that while the commercial version can travel nearly 7.5 miles with a full load, the presidential aircraft with fewer passengers and modifications to carry more fuel can fly longer without refueling. Regarding speed, there is no difference from other Il-96 types, which is 540 miles per hour. The only difference lies in the maximum speed, which is slightly faster than other Tu-96 types, at about 565 miles per hour. Besides serving as the president's mode of transportation, The third T-96 is also tasked with ensuring the president's security. The responsibility for this lies with the Russia Special Flight Squadron, officially known as SLO Russia. This is a company that provides air transportation for officials of the Russian Federation and other important figures from the Special Services of the Russian Federation, or the Armed Forces of the Russian Federation, operating under the administration of the President of the Russian Federation. Historically, in the mid-1990s, this detachment included a fleet of 65 aircraft, but this was later reduced to 38 units due to a crisis. Now, the fleet has been increased back to 60 aircraft. The procedure begins with keeping the president's movements a secret. The area where Putin is to fly is heavily guarded, and its location is not widely known. Access is only granted through special permission at checkpoints. All information is confidential, including obfuscating the aircraft's coordinates, route, and destination. These details are communicated only by a small group of individuals. If necessary, disinformation is intentionally used. According to reports, when planning a visit to a location, 2 to 4 aircraft are prepared. The specific aircraft Putin will board is chosen by him and is not communicated to anyone until he boards the aircraft. When Putin's plane takes off, 2 to 3 other aircraft follow. External protection is equally crucial. The presidential aircraft is always accompanied by a special protective unit that flies at a distance but can quickly defend the president's plane if needed. At the same time, ground-based radars actively monitor the airspace to detect other aircraft, and air defense systems are on alert for intruders and potential enemies. However, it's during takeoff and landing that extra attention is required. This is because these times are believed to be most vulnerable to potential terrorist attacks. Therefore, operators and security personnel meticulously monitor every movement of people and equipment near Putin's aircraft. This is just the procedure when Putin is set to depart. We haven't yet discussed the advanced features of the aircraft. The main feature implemented in Putin's plane is its radio electronic equipment. This allows Putin to send messages during flights anywhere in the world. The messages are also encrypted with complex codes that are nearly impossible to crack. The Tu-96-300PU is also equipped with additional protective layers, such as a special coating on the hull of the aircraft that helps hide its presence from foreign radars. This can also disrupt and confuse enemy radars to lose track of the plane. There are rumors that the aircraft is also equipped with a nuclear button to launch a pair of missiles with unprecedented power, but this has not been confirmed. As previously mentioned, Putin's aircraft is referred to as the Flying Kremlin. This means that the presidential plane doubles as transportation and a working office, as Putin reportedly spends up to 300 hours a year in the air, equivalent to the flight time of a professional pilot. From the outside, the plane might look similar to typical aircraft models, but the interior cabin is decorated luxuriously. Leaked photos show that inside the plane there's a presidential office, meeting room, conference room, and a waiting area for guests and aides. Additionally, the aircraft includes a mini gym, dining room, bar, bedroom, and bathroom, most of which are adorned with gold. However, claims about the interior photos of Putin's plane circulating on the internet are false. In reality, there are no gold toilets, giant beds, or fitness centers inside it. Despite the aircraft's luxurious neoclassical style interior, the president's work desk is made of Karelian birch wood, not gold. The exact cost of Putin's plane might be elusive, but the base model of the Tu-96-300 is sold for around $46.7 million. However, considering the expensive interior, that could cost tens of millions of dollars, the installation of costly equipment, and the special coatings on the body, it's clear that the price of Putin's aircraft is much higher than the commercial model's price. The assumption is that the development cost is around 50 to 60 million US dollars. This doesn't include the substantial annual maintenance and fuel costs, plus expenses for high-end communication and security systems. However, aircharter.co.uk estimates the value of Vladimir Putin's aircraft, complete with an in-flight management center, to be around 500 million US dollars.